Hi guys, it's Haffina. I am back again. Today is my June makeup basket. I'm a little late. It's the 5th of June today. But you know, you get busy. You don't get around to things. So the theme for this month's makeup basket is sweet. I basically went with sweet things. So there's a lot of things like cupcake and caramel and stuff like that. The other thing I did is because it's really hard to make foundations and primers and mascaras necessarily fit these themes, I have stuck to eyeshadows, blushes, and lip products as the things that I get to fit the theme, and everything else I leave, basically. So, but I'll still show you the stuff that I'm using. So the primer I'm using is the See You Later Pores from Astralis, which is basically like professional. It even looks like a professional. It's not though, and I don't really like professional. And See You Later Pores is not my favourite primer either. So I have worked out I prefer a silicone primer, like, you know, the clear ones, to this particular type of primer. I'm only putting it on the areas that really need it, and I probably need a headband. Yes, I had my hair done. I was going to find my bunny ears, but my daughter stole that the other day. So we'll go with Gucci. Oh look, the piece of fringe that doesn't want to stay. Coffee, obviously. For foundation, I can't remember what I was doing. For foundation, I'm using the NYX Total Control Drop Foundation. I probably don't use it the way you're supposed to, but I actually don't care. Which you all know by now. If I'm looking a little paler than usual, that's because it's that time of the month. Gorgeous. I have fallen in love with this fish brush. It just applies makeup so quickly and so well that it is my go-to regardless of which foundation I'm using. And I don't like really heavy coverage, so I only put it on pretty, you know, line. Not really trying to hide too many of the face demons that I currently have. A great big one there. I attacked myself. So I am drawing to the end of my first semester at uni. I have one lecture left next week. And then I have SWAT vac, and then I have my first lot of exams. Provided I do okay in the exam, my grade should be relatively good for both subjects I'm doing. Probably a P2, maybe a credit. We'll see. P2 is pass, higher level pass. P1's lower level pass, basically. For concealer, I'm using the Match Perfect from Rimmel. This isn't my favourite, but I'm trying to switch between my favourite and this one, which is pretty much the only other cream concealer I actually own at the moment. But Priceline is having a sale on, starts tomorrow, and Maybelline is going to be half price. need some more Dewy and Smooth and some more concealer. So I'm really hoping my local Priceline has my shade, because they had them half price at Coles the other day, but Coles literally has, I think it's 3 or 4 shades, and most of those are in the matte version of Fit Me, which does not look good on me at all. I have a bottle of it, I just don't use it, because it kind of makes me look even more dry and crusty than I actually am. I've got to clean my eyes, probably. I've got crusties. Grease. To set that, I'm going to use my Artist Selection HD powder like I normally do. This lasts forever because I only use a little bit just to set mainly under my eyes. A little bit through here. I don't get anywhere near as oily as I used to. Like, and that's a lot to do with the fact that I'm 44 and not 16. So like my daughter is like super duper oily at the moment. She gets lots of congestion in her forehead, and like congestion, I mean like lots of zits across her forehead, and blackheads on her nose and stuff. And it's like, yep. And she's getting them in other places like her back and stuff. And it's just like, yep. Welcome to puberty. And she's getting the worst side of it rather than the, like, I got virtually none while I was a teenager. I got them all after I had children. Yeah, figure. Okay, so let's have a look at the other things. So for contour, I'm going to use my B1. This is actually in this project, because this contour trio, which is actually in my finished 20 by 2020, is called Sweet. So I'm going to use the contour today. As you can see, I've already hit pan in this one. I don't contour every single day. Depends on how much time I've got. Like, if I'm running late in the morning to go to uni, I'll put on a bit of blush, and I'll put on eyeliner, and I'll put on mascara and do my eyebrows, and do lipstick. But I won't contour. Oh, I usually do highlighter, because, you know, highlighter. But if I've got a bit more time, then I'll do a decent eyeshadow look. And then if I've got lots of time, then I'll contour. So it's like, it's the thing you do when you know you've got plenty of time. I mean, even though it doesn't really take very long, it's like, it's one of the not necessary, like a mascara, an eyeliner, and eyebrows are a necessity. Especially when your eyebrows like mine. So that's those ones. I could use the blush out of this as well, and the highlighter, but I don't want to, even though they're the things I'm supposed to be using. They're just not what I want to use. And I have 3 different options for blush anyway. Highlighter is not something that fits the theme. It was just something that was in my collection, because I don't have enough highlighters to do that. So the 3 blushes I have to choose from, I have this one, which is in a different container. This is not its original container. This is the Strawberry Mineral Foundation from Cosmetic Kitchen. So it's a really nice muted kind of pinky mauve colour. It's really pretty. It's just super messy, as you'd expect. The Next one I have is Chi Chi Pink Peach Mosaic Blush. And then I have also from the Cosmetic Kitchen this one, which is Acai Berry, which is more purple than strawberry is. And that is the one I'm going to use today. Then we are going to go on to highlighter. As I said, this isn't one that fits the theme. This is Twilight Tint from NYX, one of their duo chromatic highlighters. Basically, it's a bit like the one, a bit like Galactic from Pretty Sweet Face. It's basically green. There's no sun today, so it's, yeah, a bit hard to see. And what I can see is probably very different from what you can see. And yes, once again, I did go too heavy on my forehead. I always do that. Makes me just look slightly alien, which is fine. Basically that done. Before I do my eyeshadow, I am going to do my brows. I am using the Cella pencil. It's actually super fine pencil, which is really good. It's just, it's a little bit on the dark side. This is in... It's actually in light brown, but it's, if you press too hard or put too much on, it's quite dark. Pretty much a colour that anybody could use, really. As long as you're really light-handed or blend it really well afterwards. And over the top of that, I am going to put some extender brow from Designer Brands, which is in my 20x20x20 project. It's basically just little fibers, and they just add some volume to your brows, which is really useful for me because I don't have any. And yes, now my brows look really dark, but I have purple hair. It doesn't really matter what colour my eyebrows are. One of the benefits of having an odd coloured hair is that you can pretty much get away with anything. Definitely sisters and not twins. And then to lock that in, I'm going to use some Tint My Brow from Astralis, which is basically just the same as any other tinted brow gel stuff. I mainly use it just to hold everything in. This is in blonde. So I'm going to zoom in and we're going to start on the eyes. So for eye primer this month, I'm using the Pro Primer from LA Girl in Nude. This one is the one that is in my Finish 20x2020 project. It doesn't fit the theme of sweet. It's literally called Nude. I suppose being nude's kind of sweet, but no, that's not. That's not what we're going for here. That was February. And yes, my nails are very different lengths on both my hands. I had to kind of do a restart on my swatching hand. Things were not going well, so I cut them back and sort of started again. But this hand actually has tips on it, so they're like quite a bit longer at the moment. I keep finding crusties in my eyes, really annoying. Okay, so for eyeshadow, we have a few choices here. So we have from Essence, we have the Essence 3D in Irresistible Caramel Cream. Knowing how much I didn't like Irresistible Chocolate, this might not last out the month. From L'Oreal, we have the Endless Chocolate Pressed Pigment. Everything is actually really neutral this month. From Makeup Geek, we have Cupcake, which is up there. I also have from Mask, I have a loose pigment. This is in Mud Cake, which it's brown. It's got a slight red tint to it, but it's basically just brown. And then I have an old palette, which part of the reason it's in here is because I just want to see whether I like it. It's basically got no mattes in it. This is from LA Colors. This is the Sweet palette, which you can't really see because it's, but it had some greens in it, and lots and lots of neutrals, but it doesn't actually have any, it has some satins, but not any real matte shades. So I'm going to use this shade here to set the eye primer. Of course, none of these have any names, but they definitely have a sheen to them, so this will be the month of, I mean, Cupcake is matte, but it's probably the colour that'll end up getting used as base transition for most of the month. This one's not too bad. I've had worse. At least you can actually see this. Which is, you know, kind of the goal. So I'm going to take one of my, I don't have a colour switch. I'm really bad at cleaning my brushes. This is a hair donut. It's the kind of thing you use to make buns if you don't have lots of hair. Not really something I need for that. But basically, you can get these for like a 2-pack for like a buck. And then when they get like really grotty, this one's starting to get really grotty, you can put them in the washing machine and it just cleans off the end of the brush. Works for me. So I'm going to go into Cupcake. Cupcake is, I don't know if I mentioned, it's a Makeup Geek shadow that I got from Tamara J ages and ages ago. And I haven't really used any of the Makeup Geek stuff very much, so this is a new experience for me. It's because they're all like single eyeshadows and they're in a magnetic palette, and it's not something I've been reaching for because I have all these other things, which is part of the reason for curating my collection, is to get it down to stuff I really like is actually a lovely transition colour. To be going to do. I think I'm going to use the same brush because I can, and I'm going to go into this one here. I don't think it's going to come out anywhere near as dark as it looks in the pan. Just going to work that into the outer corner, bring it across a little bit. The fact that this is a very cheap palette, the quality of these shadows is actually phenomenal. Like, I'm legitimately surprised. I mean, maybe just my makeup skills have improved over the years, but I think I remember when I first used them, I didn't really think much of them. Or maybe I haven't used that colour before. I've actually had these for ages and I just don't use them very much. Maybe I should use them more often because they're actually really nicely pigmented. And you saw how much I was blending those and they didn't blend away. I'm just going to go back into Cupcake and just re-blend that edge. The top there. Take it up a little bit higher. It's not like I don't have room. I have plenty of room out there. All this real estate that I don't usually use. So, on the lid, we're going to go dark or light. Alright, I'm going to go into one of the darker greens with a smaller brush. The next darker green. Which is this one here. I mean, I'm assuming it's dark. Just below that other one, and sort of a bit more onto the lid. I have coffee.
You don't want another one?
No. Just a little bit darker. Just to darken it up. I could go into the black, but I'm not going to. Just gonna work that in. Just give it a little blend. Make sure there's no harsh lines. Just like that. Alright. So, I think what I'm going to do, because I have all these other eyeshadows that I should be looking at, I'm not going to use the mask or the endless chocolate today. I no doubt will during the month. Like, I often use ones that I haven't used in this, but I only have so much eyelid space. And I'm sure I could use them just to put them on for the sake of putting them on, but that's not how I operate. So if you really want to see another look using the darker, like the dark browns, then yeah, just leave me a message down below and I'll do something about it. So I'm going to go into the light side of Irresistible Crown Rolls, and I'm going to use that for my mid shade. have so much stuff from Essence with these eyeshadows, so I'm not necessarily the best. In fact, I almost think this one would work better as a highlighter than as an eyeshadow. So I'm just going to use a bit of it on the brow bone. With a small brush, a small detailer brush, and I'm going to use that to do under my eye. Just very light. Just to darken the base of those lashes. Add a bit of definition below the eye. Nothing too crazy. And that's often how I will use a colour that is a little difficult to use, or a product that's a bit more difficult to use, is just use it as the eyeliner underneath my eyes. And as usual, one side's always slightly darker than the other. I don't know how that happens, but it always seems to happen. Anyway. Okay, so that is the basic eyeshadow done. For eyeliner, I'm using this very old one, which I've been trying to use up for ages. It's from LFR. I think I got it in a Mimi box years ago, but it just keeps on going. It isn't, obviously, in the sweet category. It's just a basic black liquid eyeliner. I think I have to set this one though. It's one thing I've noticed about the Lacura one that I've been using, which is the one that's in my Finish 20x2020, is that it doesn't need to be set. Once it dries, it doesn't really move at all, which is great. Nothing worse than liquid eyeliner that moves around all over the place. So to set that, I'm actually going to use Endless Chocolate again. It's made a mess. And that fine. This is actually an AOA Studio brush, in case you're wondering. I mean, maybe you weren't, but in case you were. The F16 from AOA Studios. And I just got brown eyeshadow everywhere. Not happy. Gonna curl my lashes. Put on some mascara. Oh yeah, I need to tight line, don't I? Evil device. My eyes are really odd shape on this side, and it's really hard to get all of the eyelashes to get in the little thingy at the same time. So the eyeliner I'm using is the Jordana Quick Liner. It was just, I think it's what I was using last month. I think I have a models code when I'm supposed to be using it. I'll check my paperwork later. This is just the one I had to hand. I actually had a different one written down on this list, and when I went to find it, I couldn't find it. So I'm wondering if I actually decluttered it and I just didn't not. Because I've realised I've decluttered stuff and not actually written it down. Which is kind of stupid, but... So, oh look, I just found the model code. It's like sitting right there. Yeah, it's just a basic black eye. Not any different from what I just used, quite frankly. So for mascara this month, I am using the Australian version of Lash Paradise. It's called Paradise Ecstatic. It's the same thing, but for some reason they called it something different here. I'm hoping now that it's dried out a little bit, because this is not the first time using it, that I like it a little bit better than I liked it the first time I used it. Okay, maybe yes. Wow. The first time I used this, I was like really not that impressed. It really didn't seem to do much for my eyelashes. But now that it's a little bit older, because I have been alternating mascaras, except my eyelashes on this side are literally sticking like straight out, which is really annoying me. But even with curling them, they didn't want to do what I wanted them to. Bottom Clump Crusher. It's the only one that doesn't, like Layla, it's the only one that doesn't transfer. I don't actually use the water-resistant one like she does, though. I just find that most other mascaras, and it's funny because it's usually the top mascara that'll end up transferring at some point. I don't know how I managed to do that. I mean, maybe it's because of the way my eyelashes sit, or they flake or something. I don't really know. So the lashes on this side look phenomenal. Not so much on this side. Oh, why are they doing that? There's a gap in my eyelashes. It's driving me crazy. Literally a gap in my eyelashes. You know, eyes are sisters, not twins. Clearly, because mine are way different to each other. Alright, so that's it for the eyes. I'm going to zoom back out and we're going to do something about the lips. Okay, so I have heaps and heaps of options for lips. Probably way more than I need. Because I am who I am. So for lip liner, I have the L'Oreal Magic, which is just a clear one, which I thought was a good idea because I have so many different colours, it would be really hard to match them all with different ones. I also grabbed out my Besame one, which is a double-ended lip liner with two different shades of red. So there's that one. And then there's this one, which... I think this one's a slightly lighter end. They look really similar until you like put them on the skin. And I think I'm probably going to go with the Besame lipstick that I put in this month, which is cherry red. which looks like that. That is that one. So that's one of the lipsticks I have. I also have Mauve Mousse from Coral Colours, which is... it's really hard to see. It's a very light nude. It's the kind of thing that I would put over something darker to make it more obvious. Sweet Pink from NYX Matte line, which, as you can guess, is pink. That was literally perfectly named. I have All About Cupcake from Essence, which is a peachy... Again, really hard to see. It's like a peachy pink shade. Another quite light one. I have one of my favourite lipsticks. This is a Dragon Fruit from Maybelline. No, L'Oreal. You can't get these ones, the balm ones, anymore. And I love these. They feel so nice. Oops. So that is Dragon Fruit right there. It's a really good one when you just want to chuck something on your lips, but you don't want to go too intense. I have Boysenberry from Anoxa. I had two Anoxa ones in last month, and I really enjoyed wearing those. Particularly Poppy. I wore Poppy like twice because it was so nice. And it actually turned out to be a matte lipstick, and it lasted like ages, even with like eating and drinking. I was surprised. And then I have a couple of lip pencils. I have this one, which I don't know what brand it is, but it's called Pink Sherbet. And it's this kind of weird orangey pink. It's sort of a strange colour, but I don't know. And I also have from Revlon's Balm Stain Honey, which again is another nude, so you can see there's lots of very pinky shades, and that Bessemer one is really the only super bright one. And then I have one liquid lipstick, which is Pav Lover from Astralis. Which is a darker shade. Not that much darker, but it is a bit darker. I have the NYX Butter Gloss in Angel Food Cake, which I got because lots of people were like, oh, it's the perfect colour. Then I realised it's just a little bit too... It's quite light. It's not necessarily what I go for. And lastly... I think it's the last one. Yes, it is. That was something else. We have Sugared Honey from Maybelline, I believe. Which is just a quite pigmented lip gloss. And they smell so nice. I've had them for ages. I've got a few of them. They're gorgeous. So I'm going to take... I've got to wake up. I'll show you with this Bessemer. So, the end towards the E is that colour. And the end towards the B is that colour. So, that one is B. And so, you can see it's a slightly darker shade. But they're so similar, like, you can barely tell the difference. But I'm going to use the E end, the slightly lighter one, because it's the one that matches Cherry Red a little better. was listening to Aiden the other day, and she was saying how she doesn't know how to force herself to use lip liner. See, the thing is as you get older, your lips will bleed. So, like, using a colour like this, it'll feather into fine lines around your mouth, and you'll get fine lines around your mouth whether you like it or not. And it will be a problem at some point. And I know this to be true because, I mean, I'm only 44, but I did used to smoke, so I have fine lines around my lips. And yes, I think it was yesterday or the day before, Monday, I didn't actually put lip liner on with Poppy. And I could see, like, particularly around here, by sort of like halfway through the day, there was feathering starting out here. That's why you use lip liner, is because it stops that from happening. Also makes your lipstick last longer, and if your lipstick does start to wear, like, particularly if you're filling your whole lip, even if your lipstick does start to wear off, the lip liner tends to stay, and so you still have some colour on your lips. It makes the wearing off of your lipstick not quite so obvious. So I'm going to put on cherry red. The other thing I find really interesting is that I've known about Besame for probably 4 years now, and they're only, like, in the last sort of, like, 2 years have only just, like, really hit their stride. But I bought these in 2000 and it was more like 5 years, I'm pretty sure I bought these in 2014 at a trade show in Australia. So I've always been kind of surprised when people are like, oh, Besame. It's like, yeah, they've been around for ages. But yeah, now that they're starting to do more, like, pop culture type of thing, people pay attention to them more, I guess. Because I actually have two Besame lipsticks and the lip liner, and I've had them for ages. And they're actually still good. It's quite a form. This one is actually quite firm, and I think the other one I've got, which is Cherry Noir, which is dark, is much softer. This one's quite a firm kind of thing, but yeah. Useless tidbit. so that is one makeup look from my makeup basket for June. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there, click little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup baskets and makeup look type videos, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.